So Jordan become not home anymore too, right? So they did my case in the United Nations as a refugee, and then I picked Canada. Mm-hmm. Because I know Canada is the most fine country. Mm-hmm. And the human rights here, and so I don't need to fight anymore.
And you're free to create art and have the Islamic influence, the Sumerian influence, the Western influence. You can put it all together and create something brand new and that develops. In your paintings, some of them, I noticed the paint spills over to the frame. What is the symbolism behind the paint getting out of the borders?
Freedom. Mm-hmm. From my perspective, the civilization categorize us and put us in the boxes, mm-hmm. which is started like really, and then you have to paint and put a frame for it to make it more beautiful.
Yes.
Right. Framing things is limit. Mm-hmm. Our power as human beings, we are unlimited. Mm-hmm. Our soul is unlimited.
Yes.
Our bodies is limited.
So the body is the frame.
The body is the frame.
That has to be transcended.
Yeah. Mm.
In making art mainstream, something interesting has happened. The Roundhouse Theater has actually asked you to give another one of your shows of Anu. But this time, instead of you choosing artists and having them do the improvisation, they want you to get the audience involved. And so we're coming full circle to your dream of allowing the participants to be the creators. How are you going to do this?
I'd love to take the risk.
Okay.
It's a risk. It's mm-hmm. going to be, the audience is going to be there for 50 minutes. And I'm going to try to use moving light, like I can move it from the bow. So there's no setup for the lighting. Mm-hmm. So the light actually moves like I.
Oh, I see.
And capture the people. And I invited also a few artists to help out. Mm-hmm. To set up the mood.
To draw the audience into performing.
And you, if you come and play. And mm-hmm. I know you're a very fantastic pianist.
Thank you.
And lots of friends, when they heard about that, they said, yeah, we'll bring an instrument. We're coming.
Wow.
Yeah. And I've been asked like before, and they asked the Roundhouse audience members to try it out. Or to, you know, they wish they have a chance to perform mm-hmm. during the show, but that's a level, that's a new level completely.
I see. I noticed that when you were sketching earlier on, and I was looking very carefully, there was a complete, it seemed like there was a complete independence of your hand from the rest of you. It was as if it was already moving by itself, and it was poetry. You lifted your hand off as if the hand were breathing. It was quite a dance to see. In your training, that was very classical. How difficult was it to get to the stage where the vision and the hand cooperated so well that they almost became independent of each other?
That's how always when I used to teach, the first day is to tell them a theory of how you connect your hand to your mind,
mm-hmm.
which is most people, average people, they don't have.
Mm-hmm.
How to connect your hand to your vision, to your eyes. And that's make it the first question for the students to answer.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, when you look at things in different lighting, different, you know, you see the thing itself, like for example a vase, right? And you try to imitate that on the paper.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever you do, if you don't practice, our vision, our visual skills is illiterate at that moment.
Oh.
So you need to learn how to look first.
I see.
So what I used to do, I bring a tinfoil and wrinkle it and put it in front of students and put different lights on it and I'd tell them, paint, I would draw.
Mm-hmm.
Student, after 15 minutes, just started to cry.
Really?
Yeah. Because
it was that traumatic.
It is impossible
to
draw the tinfoil, all that reflections and shades and different really fine tones of shades.
Oh, I see.
So they start to active their eyes.
Oh.
Then I put something simpler. Their eyes are more active and they can see better.
Oh, I see.
So we look at things we don't see. So that's how you've started to connect your body to your mind. Like, for example, first time if you never played soccer before?
No.
If I give you the field and play with the really well-trained players, your body, if you receive the ball, your body will move the way you imagine to move, like the other good players, but your body's not going to move like that.
That's right.
Because you're not practicing.